Hi there, my name is Sophie Walker and today I'm here with Golfalot. Now if you're new to this channel, please click the like, the subscribe button and ring the bell. Today I'm reviewing the TaylorMade P770 irons. They look great and I can't wait to try them. The P770 is a similar looking club to the P790. Now that was a massive success of you guys. I loved it also. Turned it straight at it. Yeah, lovely shot. Actually flew quite well and a little bit longer than I would have thought. But nice strong flight. I'd be really happy with this as a long iron. The only problem was I got that hot six iron that went 160 and it scared me a bit. I'm hoping not to find that today. Looks wise, the P770 is a smaller version of the P790. Smaller head, thinner top edge, and a bit more loft to it, more traditional loft. I'm excited to give these a go. Let's get into the tech. Now, TaylorMade have packed a lot into this small head. And that's the first thing they talk about, the shape, a compact player's shaping, a smaller profile basically. A forged hollow body construction, speed foam, which increases ball speed, but doesn't hinder the feel apparently. A through slot speed pocket, which is this line here, once again, increases ball speed and helps with forgiveness if you hit it off the bottom, apparently. And a progressive inverted cone technology. Now these are all phrases that you've heard before, standard TaylorMade tech. But I tell you what, it is looking good, this iron. My first hit with the P770s, will they perform as good as they look? Oh, they shape the golf ball so well. A lovely head. Solid sound. What I'm liking is there's a spin number there. They're not too low spinning, they're doing a true loft. You can really feel the ball on the club face. It's like it stays there for a touch longer. Not quite my normal six iron carry yet. I would be looking to get this over 150. So let's see if it's me or the golf club. Come on, Soph. That was nice. Yeah, not quite getting the distance, but a nice consistency in the ball flight. Now these lofts are 2.5 degrees weaker than the P790s. Which would probably explain the spin rate up and the lack of distance. The sound's good though. I like that dull, not tingy sound. It's just a solid strike. And every one of these shots are doing what I think they'll do. You know, if I catch it fat and left, it's going short and left. They're reacting to how I'm swinging and making contact. Going to try hit some fades, draws, check out the workability of these irons. I've got the TrackMan and the Pro V1X like normal. So let's try and hit a little fade. Straight off the face, I'm like, fade. I don't even need to see that on there. Let's go for a draw. Looks like I left it out there a touch. Might start coming back. Yeah, so I'm calling the shot and then seeing it, which is exactly what I'd expect with this type of golf club. Now the draw went nearly 150. So there's a bit more yardage in the draw for obvious reasons. Tell you what, let's go for low fade. So height on that one was 75 and I'm averaging 82, so it's definitely flighted down. Go for the high draw. There you go, there's the high draw. Notice it was 87 feet, slight right to left on it. These are lovely, really easy to control, and as soon as you hit it, you can call the shot. Shaft wise, I'm playing the KBS Tour 120 stiff. These are not for me. I normally use a graphite with 90 grams, but that would definitely help with my swing speed, and I think I'd get some more distance as well. So just bear that in mind, go get custom fit. I am now going to hit a few P790 six irons in comparison, just to look at distance, spin, and the difference between the two. That wasn't a great strike, that was out the bottom, but ball speed jumped up and distance did straight away. I can feel the lightness in the shaft on this one, so this shaft is slightly better for me. Now that was louder, wasn't it? But straight off the face, I was like, that was quick. And I've gained a good 6 or 7 yards. I'm now getting to my normal six iron length. Looking at the comparison between the two irons. Now feel wise for me, P770s were right up there. But then when I put the P790s in my hand, the distance was what I required. If only I could have both. But you can, if you swing it faster than me and your ball speed is quicker than me, then the P770s might be ideal. Now, when I hit the 155 yard carry six iron, it came off quick. That didn't scare me. But if you're swinging your irons at 90 odd mile an hour, that's gonna scare the life out of you. So I totally understand. This is where the P770s will be more your type of iron. Looking at the difference between the two, P770 averaged 8 yards less. The spin was closer to 6,000. But workability for me was a lot easier. These clubs are saying exactly what TaylorMade is wanting. They've got better feel, they've got better shape. They might not go quite as far for somebody like me. They're more traditional in looks, feel, and distance. That's my indoor testing finish. Now let's head out onto Stockport Golf Club. Welcome to sunny Stockport Golf Club. I'm gonna play a few holes with the P770s, try some different scenarios, real-time golf conditions. Yards to the flag, wind's a little bit out the right, six iron. I'm going to try and hit a touch of draw with this wind, maybe slightly into as well. Straight at it, yeah, but it's short. Thought I hit that okay. Right, that's good to know. It's not going as far as I thought. Obviously, it's similar to what they were inside, so I'm gonna have to adapt to that. But strike-wise felt good, and it was straight at the flag. Just need a bit more on, so. Don't you hate it when it's all over the flag and it's a club short, 10 yards short. But it does give me an opportunity to have a go with a wedge, a little chip and run. It's important to try irons in all different scenarios, okay? So don't just hit seven irons when you go and practice with them, and get a wedge out, do a bit of a feel shot as well. Need to be a bit harder, but yeah, straight in the middle, nice feel. The second hole gives me a perfect opportunity to hit a four iron off the tee, because it's only a layup hole, slight left to right shape. So I'm going to try and hit a nice fade off the far bunker. Moved a touch, let's see what it's like. That four iron went 175 off the tee, which is good. I've now got an eight iron in my hand, noticing that the speed pocket has disappeared in the shorter irons. They do look offset. I didn't notice it in the six iron inside or the four iron, but yeah, this eight iron is a bit offset. 123 yards up the hill. slightly downwind. Try to work that one in right to left. Just missed the flag left, but yeah, that was good. As you can see from this pitch mark, it stopped really quick and it was downwind. The greens are soft though, so bear that in mind. I tried to play what I would normally play there, kind of a 3/4 8-iron downwind. So downwind, they're kind of doing what I expect them to do. It's just into wind, not quite enough oomph. Oh, the third's into wind, so I'm gonna try and hit a low drawing 4-iron. See how the ball flies and how it feels. That came off nice. Got a bit of release on it as well. Did exactly what I wanted. With these irons, I can shape them, but I've had to over exaggerate to get that draw and fade. Now I know I don't hit in the rough, but I'm here to show you all scenarios, so let's see the forgiveness out of the wet stuff. So that's not a great lie. I might give myself a flyer lie to start with. I think that's important as well to see how much these go. So I'll give myself a flyer lie, 156 iron. See what this looks like. Came out really high. Yeah, got there nicely. Now that's not too great. Slightly heavy, but it's got there. Right then, let's try and give myself something, yeah, half decent, okay? Stability wise so far, it's good, the club's not wrapped round. Now that one did, but not as much as it could have. I definitely thought it was gonna turn over and it just hung on long enough. Excellent forgiveness from this rough. I'm happy with all these three because distance wise they were similar and the stability of the face, there's not a lot of difference left and right. Granted, I didn't get to the flag, but I didn't expect to from those lies. Stability and forgiveness, they're good with these irons. My verdict on the P770s, they're quite expensive, £185 each, so that's £12.99 for seven, but I would expect this from such a nice looking golf club. Personally, they didn't go far enough for me, so the P790s is something that I would want to go for, but that's my issue of ball speed and club speed. If you did find the P790s a bit too much game improving, this definitely sits in between them and the blades. Workability wise, yeah, you could do it. I had to try a bit harder than I would like for this type of golf club. It's doing what TaylorMade want it to do. It's not going as far as the P790s. It's got that bit more forgiveness than the other blades towards the end. So it's fitting in the middle. I just wonder who this will cater for. I think you're either going to be a P790 player or a P7 MCMB. But, you know, give them a try. They're a very nice looking golf club. And see for yourself. If they just went a touch longer, the sound and the feel is better than the P790. But just be mindful of that. So if you're one of the lucky ones that hit the P790s too far, go and try these P770s. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please comment below, subscribe, like, ring the bell. If you want to read the written review, go on to golfalot.com. Thanks for watching and I'll see you again soon.